In this video, we are going to see how to use a very powerful resource of Flutter platform, that is the setState method. The widgets that represents the application screens are able to display a set of informations, and with the setState method, we can, with a single method call, update all informations in the screen. Just updating single variables and all the places in the screen where this variable is referentiated, the value is also updated. So we could do things like that. Here we have an object with one name and one email, and when we choose change to another object, it automatically updates the entire screen. So the state of the screen could be handled in a very simple manner with the setState method. So we can change the variables values in user interface without a great effort. So let's see how this effect was implemented. Basically here we have one widget, and in this widget we have two attributes that are the name and the email. And we present the name and the email in the interface inside its layout that is here defined. So here we have a text field component that displays the name variable. We use the dollar at the front of the variable name. So the text displays the name, and here is another text display the email that are going to be presented in the screen. And below we have the text form fields if user wants to edit that. So it's like the user edition form interface. Okay, and then we have two buttons in the interface, the show state B and the show state A. Okay, we have these two buttons at the interface that are here represented, show state B and show state A. And what happens when user press here to change the status and press here to change to another state? Let's take a look. Here on the onPress property of the text button, we can then inform the method that are going to be executed. So if you open this method that is here implemented, basically we set a new object to the contact variable we have. So here's the implementation of setState A and the implementation of setState B. And we just assign new values to this object, and we call this updateState method. Actually, this updateState method just is a wrapper to this implementation. And then here it is, the setState, a very powerful method for the Flutter platform, that the variables we change here, because we could make the update of these variables outside this method. It will work, the update of the variables, but the text elements in the screen will not be automatically refreshed, automatically updated. When we want to change the variable, here the variable is defined. When we want to change the variable value and then automatically update the variables in the screen, we have to make these assignments inside the setState method. Then just doing that, these two variables here, we have then this effect for change status A, change state B, and so on, because it's setState. But then we have one additional thing here in this example. We have this form data. These text fields here, they are handled not by these variables, but by its controller components. So when we have here the fields designed in the screen, the text form field elements, they are handled by this controller. So we have one controller for the name and another controller for the email. And then for the text to be here displayed as well, we do not update with the setState. We then has to update the controller itself. Then that was the reason we have created this wrapper method. Then we do not have to duplicate this code. So that was the implementation that allows us with a single object assignment update all information in the user interface, having then this kind of effect, changing then all fields, text elements, and edit text elements in the user graphical interface. So that was the goal for this video, explanation about how to use the setState method, and also give you some hints about how to use the edit text controller. Thank you for watching.